Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil anbiya, al mursaleen, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Alhamdulillah, we are embarking on our life coach training program, which inshallah we hope to train throughout the world 10,000 life coaches, which we are giving free. Yeah? And this is by our Khalifa Education Foundation and Islamic Psychology Center, so that we can then help the Ummah to adapt and face the challenges of the 21st century. In the previous video, I have given you the answer to some of the challenges of atheism in the 21st century, how the dominant worldview of humanity today is atheism and why it's going to affect the Ummah if we are not able to confront and help our young people to face these challenges. Number two, we are talking about maintaining our Islamic religiosity and how we can then bring about to save our younger generation. And number three, today I'm going to talk about overcoming the negative perception of Islam. All right, so if we are talking about negative perception of Islam, we must understand that there are both areas of negative perception. One is internal, one is external. All right, so if we talk about the internal, we have a lot of weaknesses within the Ummah. And we talk about external, there is a lot of geopolitical as well as agenda by the so-called superpowers. From the Islamic perspective, all the superpowers in the world, they are not superpowers. They're just, Allah has given them the authority for the time being to lead, especially the Western world or the communist world or whatever it is. All right. So all of them have their own agenda. And their agenda is to make sure that Islam cannot grow. But or Islam is, as a religion, will be a spent force and will be then be degraded into a non-entity. This is their game plan, all right? In terms of geopolitics, in terms of economics, in terms of injustice, in terms of oppression, in terms of conflict, in terms of wars, in terms of mass starvation, in terms of killing, genocide, and so all these are happening in the 21st century. It's still happening. But those are the external perception that is making Islam look bad. All right, the whole idea is they want to demonize Islam so that people are not attracted to this deen, this beautiful deen. Non-Muslims are not attracted to become Muslims, and Muslims in the long run loses their religiosity. So this is the game plan. But we have Allah. Remember, the game plan of all those in this dunya, whether they are the superpowers, whether they are politicians, whether they are president, whether they are a country that is doing all these things, these are temporary phenomena. All right? Alhamdulillah, we Muslims have faced those challenges for the last 1,400 years. And we will continue to face, because that is the reality of this dunya. But if we are going to take proactive action, then we have to strengthen ourselves in terms of, example, the external threat. Then we Muslims must work together. We must have more unity, less of the sectarian violence among ourselves, less of the evil that is being generated within the Ummah. So if we know the external threat as such that wants to extinguish the Nur or the light of Islam, we must then work together to bring this light of Allah, because Allah tells us in the Quran that non-Muslims yearn to extinguish this light of Allah with their words, with their propaganda. But Allah has ordained that this deen will supersede all deen. That means this Islamic worldview of the belief in Allah, the belief in one God, the belief of the goodness of Iman, of Islam, Iman and Ihsan, of bringing humanity towards a beautiful world, that is part and parcel of this deen. And this is where we Muslims must show an example. Right now, in the 21st century, we are not showing good example. But inshallah, over time, as more and more individual Muslims realize the need for positive Islamic worldview, not a negative, sectarian, conflict-bound worldview, then we would then gather together. So this is like our effort, like we are doing life coach training program, to reach out to you, whether you are a student, whether you are a university graduate, whether you are unemployed or employed, you are a teacher, a scholar, a professor, a retiree, a housewife, or whatever it is. We want to embrace this idea that Islam as a deen will grow in the 21st century and Islam as a deen can live with all other people in the world. Not only that, we can live with all communities, all humanities in the world, regardless of their race, their color, their educational level, their religious, whatever it is, their background, we can live with them, and we try to bring all of us together towards a new dawn of a new postmodern, post-materialistic civilization, a holistic civilization based on love, mercy, compassion, gratitude, which is part and parcel of the deen. This is the deen of love, of mercy, of compassion, and of gratitude. So we bring all these ideas and this ideal into our life, and to do that, inshallah, we have to undergo some sort of training. So this life coach training program is to prepare you first to make ourselves good. That means we strive to have additional new knowledge in terms of positive Islamic psychology, in terms of transforming ourselves from negative worldview to positive worldview, from being aggressive, from being very confrontational, to be able to live and adapt and show the beauty of this deen, the love and the beauty of this deen to all humanity. And also we then will be able to work together with all humanity, because we are facing this existential threat of an ecological disaster within the next 50 years. Now we're having the sixth mass extinction of all species. More than 70% of the fishes in the ocean are gone. All right? The coral reef are dying because of temperature rise more than 2 degrees. So within our lifetime, 50 years from now, maybe half of the world population will face mass starvation. Because when all the animals, the insects, the species of fish and even bacteria and so on start dying, we would finally be dead, because we are all interconnected in one world, we are all interconnected in one universe, we are all interconnected being the servant of Allah. So Allah created us to be His Khalifa on this earth, to make ourselves good, to help others good, and to make this world good in a way that we can then lead humanity towards replicating in some small measure this dunya, to have peace, happiness, success, justice, so that we replicate the whole idea of Jannah. Not at a full level of Jannah, because in the spiritual world, the full of level of Jannah is so immense that it is beyond all imagination. But within our life, we try to strive to make ourselves exemplars to all other human beings, and that is the goal in which we must do for ourselves, for our children, for our grandchildren, and so on. And to do that, we must be united in serving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have and learn the knowledge. So I encourage you to go through our program in terms of how we are going to overcome the negative perception of Islam today, by thinking about how you can create your own solutions and do whatever you can within your capacity as individual. For us, for me as an individual, and being part of the Khalifa Education Foundation and the Positive Islamic Psychology Center, we have our book, Positive Islamic Psychology, A Transcendent Model to Achieve Peace, Happiness and Success. This book also, inshallah, will be made into an e-book, and you can download free of charge. All right? You go to our islamicpsychology.net, you can download this whole book. Because we are not here to make profit, but we're here to spread the positive message of Islam to all humanity, especially for Muslims, so that we can then help them understand. So we have more than 450 videos. You can go through the videos, pick 30 videos, and then join us at our life coach training program. We don't charge you anything, but we also welcome donations so that we can continue this effort until we complete this within the grace and the mercy of Allah, to achieve what we can, to achieve great success, blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to move on to understand our role as the sincere servant of Allah, as His Khalifa on this earth, always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, and making the world good, inshallah.